This may be the most surprising pour we've had in all of our Monday videos, I
Wow.
think.
I think so, just because of it's so young. Welcome to the channel, bringing your real world perspective to the real world whiskey consumer.
I'm Josh.
And I'm Erin.
And this is what we are now calling Pours Unknown. So, we used to call this our first sip series where we tried something that we have never tried before and it's totally blind. Not altogether any different now, other than the fact that we're still trying samples that you guys send in. However, it doesn't necessarily have to be something we haven't tried.
Right.
It probably will be because we like to keep that in there. We don't want that familiarity with the product. But, you know, maybe we've tried it once or twice,
Right.
and then this gives us the latitude to maybe weave in some very standard samples that aren't, you know, some regular products. So this gives us a little more latitude to make the content hopefully more helpful and informative for you guys, probably entertaining as well. We're gonna nose
Absolutely.
it, taste it, go through the whole process, rank it before we find out the price. Then we'll find out the price and see if that changes our ranking before we find out what we're drinking. This way, you get the most honest opinions possible. So let's get right into it
Yeah,
on the
let's
nose.
do it. I'm getting a little funkiness, a little stinky feet, but a lot of alcohol.
Yeah, it's pretty potent in the glass. The
Yeah.
nose is jumping out of the glass to me. To me, this is just like a berry, caramel, oaky conglomeration. It smells really good to
Yeah, it
me.
also smells like a 4x4. No, 2x4. That's what it's called. A
Well, they
2x4.
make wood in 4x4 as well,
Well,
or six by
I mean a
twos,
2x4, like a standard
or right.
2x4, like a fresh one from Home Depot.
Yeah, that's really interesting. To me, it's I think maybe that's because there's a lot of oakiness there and there's some sharpness, but it's not to me coming across like brand new lumber or anything like that. All right, let's get this thing on the palate.
Yeah.
Cheers.
This tastes like good classic whiskey.
Whoa, that is sweet, powerful,
It is powerful, but
oily.
not offensive.
No, man, that tastes really good. That tastes really good. Just on first sip, first impressions, you often can't taste or trust the first sip.
Right, we
Sometimes
need.
you can't even taste the first sip. You
It's
just
true.
you have to get acclimated to what's in the glass. So let's get it on the palate again.
Oh, I got some caramel butterscotch
Yeah,
on my second
it's
sip.
got that going on. It's got that berry sweetness, but it's dark.
Yeah,
It's like a dark berry sweetness.
I'm not getting berry. I'm
Really?
getting like
That's
caramel
all over my
butterscotch
tongue.
and then 2x4.
Yeah, it's okay. This is wild. Caramel butterscotch, 2x4, berry compote, dark, all the berries, but there's
Yeah.
some dark ones in there too. And oakiness for me, it's sticky, it's oily. This tastes really, really good.
And
I'm quite impressed.
the second sip is staying around. Ooh. Staying around a lot longer than the first one. Actually, I think
Yeah.
it builds on itself because
Yeah.
the second sip is, I'm feeling it.
Yeah, I'm getting a lot of sweet oak on the finish. The way that the fruity sweetness is combining with the oak is leaving just like this lingering sweetness in my
Yeah.
mouth. It's almost like if you eat candy, like I've used this before, but like sprees. Chewy sprees are darker in flavor than something like a sweet tart. Sweet tarts are more bright, they have
Yeah.
that tartness to them,
Yeah, okay.
and then sprees are just more like sugary, concentrated sweetness.
Yeah.
That's what I'm getting out of this glass.
Okay.
So this is going to be one to spend some time with. It's going to be really interesting. We're going to do that now, not talking to the camera so we can give this thing some proper ratings or rankings or whatever you call them, and then we'll be right back with our full thoughts if anything changes and finding out what we're drinking. This one was pretty straightforward.
Yeah.
Didn't have to think too hard about it. Not a lot changed as we spent more time with it. You have anything to say before we get our ratings out here
Well,
after spending time with it?
I will say it did get a little sweeter for me as I sipped it. So that definitely makes me think it's a bourbon, but that's about the only change that I noticed.
Yeah. To me personally, it reminded me a lot of a Buffalo Trace product. Buffalo Trace. I don't know why I said it that
Don't know
way.
why you said it
It
that
reminds
way.
me a lot of a Buffalo Trace product. Honestly, it reminds me a lot of a Weller product, which I'm surprised you
Interesting.
like it if that's even anywhere in this
I
wheelhouse.
don't think it's Weller's usually weeded. right?
Right.
I don't think...
You don't typically like wheated bourbon because you get a funkiness on it.
Although I did say I got a little bit of funkiness on the nose.
Yeah.
If you recall. But it was not off-putting funkiness. It wasn't like a weed, what I normally get for wheated
funkies. Yeah. To me, this has all those hallmark Buffalo Trace, wheated bourbon type of things going on with it without the funkiness. Mm-hmm. It's very sweet. It's very sweet, concentrated sweetness that just sits on your palate. And when that sweetness for me is very youthful and, mm-hmm. you know, grainy kind of, that to me is something I don't love.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I don't mind it. I can drink it if it's an inexpensive pour, but I don't want to spend a lot of money for it.
Gotcha.
But if it's this type of concentrated, dense, berry compote type sweetness, like I feel like we went out to breakfast this morning and we had like this, I don't know what it was called.
It was a Belgian waffle with a berry compote.
Yeah. And that right there, this is like that, except it also has
an alcohol
raspberry.
Burn.
Well, that. It has alcohol in it and raspberries and strawberries in addition to the blackberries and blueberries that they had in that thing. But this is really good. I like it a lot. You got some ratings?
Yeah, I'm going to give it a thumbs up. It's solid.
You like it?
Yeah, I like it. It's a solid pour. For me, it's going to come down to price.
Yeah. I'm actually going to give this one 2 thumbs up.
Oh, wow.
It's Dang. It's a soft 2 thumbs up. I could go thumbs up on it. I like it.
All right.
Kind of love it. But it's not, it's going to depend on price whether I stay there or not.
Okay.
That's going to be the biggest factor here. So let's go ahead and pull our sample and our key up.
Yep.
This is number 89 in our Pours Unknown key. I've got to break myself of saying first sip key.
Mm-hmm.
But in our Pours Unknown key, this is number 89. So price first.
So this pour is $70. Well, this bottle.
Okay. At $70, how do you feel about that?
I'm not mad at it. I don't feel like that's asking too much.
Yeah.
But I don't know if I would spend my money on it. I don't think it's in my flavor profile enough to spend my money on it.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just going to go down to just okay.
You're going to go down to just okay.
But that being said, it is worth the money if you like this flavor profile to me.
I am going to go from 2 thumbs up down to 1 thumbs up.
Okay.
I'm going to go thumbs up. I like it, borderline love it, but once I find out the price, for me, 2 thumbs up means I have to have a bottle of it.
Mm.
I will go out of my way to get a bottle of it. I don't have to have a bottle of this. It's very good. I would like a bottle of this, hence the thumbs up.
Yeah.
It's not take it or leave it.
Mine's take it or leave it.
I would like a bottle of this, but I don't have to have it. So let's find out what we've been drinking.
All right.
This is?
It is a Hard Truth Sweet Mash Rye. Batch 2.
Are you kidding me?
Definitely did not think this was a rye. This is thanks to Nate Souza. So thank you, Nate.
The Souza. Thank you,
and
man.
And this is 115.2 proof, which I did think it was kind of that proof because it built.
It is so sweet.
I did not think it was a rye at all.
I did not. It is incredible. It's candy sweet.
It is. It doesn't hit you. Well, it didn't hit me super sweet at first, but the more I sipped it, it built on itself in proof to me and then also in sweetness. So
this is wild.
I was like convinced this was a bourbon because it was so sweet.
Yeah. Like our sample pool for our Pours Unknown is fairly large.
Mm-hmm.
So we're never trying to think about what things could be.
Right.
But I know that we don't have, this to me came across like a really, really good Weller full proof store pick. That like some of the best ones I've ever had, because the proof point's there, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's like 115-ish.
Mm-hmm.
So the proof point was up there like a Weller full proof store pick, but we don't have anything like that in our sample pool. We don't have any Weller products around that proof point. I am legitimately impressed.
Yeah.
This is Nashville, Indiana 2-year rye.
Well, I would never have guessed that it was 2 years old.
This is insane that they can do this.
It drinks youngish, but not 2 years.
Well, that's that sharpness that we were getting.
Yeah.
This isn't, I'm having a really tough time trying to articulate thoughts right now.
It's okay.
This is wild, okay? I've seen this bottle on the shelf.
Yeah.
It may be 3 years now. It may be up to 3 years age now. But this is the type of thing that it exists out there in the market.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody really knows what it is because it's fairly new to market.
Yeah.
It's a fantastic pour for the specs on paper.
Yeah.
The price is up there, though, because they're a very small local distillery. This is not sourced distillate.
Mm.
This is their own distillate. They're making this stuff in Indiana. So they got to charge a little bit more for it. But man, if you want to surprise some people, get a bottle of this Hard Truth Sweet Mash Rye.
Rye.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm stunned. I've passed this bottle on the shelf.
I'm a little shook.
Now, Here's the thing. I've passed this bottle on the shelf at $70 because I heard people say it was good, but I was like, ah.
Well, it was 70 an unknown. Bucks.
It was an unknown. And now I know, and now I'm going to go buy a bottle of this.
So are you going back to two thumbs up?
No, I don't have to have a bottle of it. I would just like a bottle of it.
That's fair.
So there we go. Hopefully this was informative and entertaining to you guys. This seems straight down the middle of home plate to me.
Yeah.
Until the reveal.
Yeah.
One more sip real quick. Wow. Yeah. It doesn't even have a whole lot of rye spiciness.
Mm-mm.
Like there's no prickliness on your tongue. I can kind of now, knowing it's a rye,
mintiness.
Feel like I get a little bit of mintiness on the finish in the middle of the back of my tongue.
I was thinking that too, but it was only after I found out it was a rye. I drank it again and I could get some mintiness, but not before I found out it was a rye.
This, if you are a Buffalo Trace or Weller fan and you have tried any ryes you like, or if you never tried ryes you like, this is a bottle to check out.
Yeah.
I'm confident saying that. Stunned. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this. If you liked the video, give it a like. If you like the style of content, subscribe because we're going to bring it to you every week. Mm-hmm. And if you want to get in on barrel picks that we do with other channels, with the community, check that out in the video description below. Tons of fun stuff happening over on Patreon.
Yeah, so much fun. And I think that's it for today. There's not much more we can say. So be good to each other. And until next time,
cheers. Cheers.
Welcome to the channel, bringing you a real-world perspective to the real world.
That hung up there a little bit?
That felt like a lot of words.